Hello, my friends. In this second part, we will see also some games from the World Chess Rapid Championship. The next game is between Vutyugov with white and Van Forres with black. It is also from the first round, okay? e4 c5, we have the Sicilian defense, knight f3, d6, and now knight c3 first, and white choose to play a very rare combination, not to go to the open Sicilian, and played e5. After d takes e5, knight takes e5, e6, bishop b5 was played. Also here, knight d7 is quite a normal move, with the idea later to play a6. Black choose to play bishop d7, it's quite okay, of course. White took the knight with the knight on d7, knight took on d7, castle a6 and bishop b2. Now, after queen c7, I think white played d4. Maybe, objectively, is not a good move, but they want to exchange some pieces, okay, to open files, to go to the endgame with the two bishops. So, d4 now is maybe not so good because black can play rook d8. But okay, bishop d6 was played, and after g3, white bring the queen to the center and can exchange some pieces with knight e4. Take on f6 and queen e4. Knight c5, queen f3, and rook d8. Now, I like very much this c3 move because white wants to stop the power of the black bishop on f6. And also, they give some the d3 square a little bit, the weak. The weaken the d3 square, but is not so important now because the bishop can control it very well. After rook c8, rook b1 and b5, white play h4. Quite an interesting idea. Maybe black has to play e5, but white still has a little small advantage after e4 and queen g4. So, knight d7, bishop f4, bishop e5, bishop g5, bishop f6, bishop f4. b5 and bishop e3. Of course, white wants to keep the two bishops. Okay, knight b6 and rook d1. I like this move because after knight d5 or knight c4, there is this bishop c1. Okay, white has a marginal advantage, of course, but his position is easier to play. Okay, and h5 now. Maybe bishop d3 is a little bit better, but also is not so bad, but after h6 and bishop d3, black has to play immediately something like b4. Okay, because we see when all the pieces are targeting one very important strategical point, you have to attack this point. After c4, knight f6, black open this bishop to put some pressure. After b3 has some ideas with a5 and a4, so it has counter chances. After bishop d3, knight f6, but very well played a3. Very good. And now, of course, black has to play a5 immediately. Black played rook d5. And after bishop b1, try to take the open file. It's a very important file because it's the only open file. But this is black is playing according to white's plan. Because after the exchange of the d-line, white has the two bishops in the endgame. What is the plan that they start already in the opening? Maybe king f8 is the logical move now to bring the king in the center. Queen d6, take and bishop d3. The problem we see that when you have the two bishops, the problem for black is in the color that his bishop cannot control. So here the problem for black is in the light squares. And with these two pawns, white can attack these two pawns immediately. Okay, now I think knight d7 is a very good move to protect everything. Black took on h5, and white played a very good move, b4, but after bishop c7, I think they played not a good move. Okay, if you play bishop e4, nothing because black has time to bring the knight to attack the c3 pawn with very good counter chances. I think the best move is to play, okay, king g2, knight f6, and this very good move. The idea is that white wants to play c4, but they don't want to allow black to play a5 to exchange one more pawn. That's why bishop d2 is very good now. After knight d7, c4 is slightly in white's favor. Okay, knight b8, white can bring the king to the center, and white is slightly better. Okay, black has a pawn, but white is better in this position. In the game, black played, white played c4, and after he takes c4, black played very well a5. It's very, very good move. So bishop d2, take and take with the bishop. Very good, because white want to have an a pawn passed pawn, not a b pawn. Okay, far away from the black king. So because they will use this pawn to decoy the black king to go there. So white will penetrate from the other side, from the king side. Bishop b6, king g2, knight f6, a4, knight g4, a5. Now, after bishop take f2, this is a good move because white can play simply bishop e2. So bishop a7 was played, bishop a1 protect the pawn, king f8, bishop e2, and now also this is possible, knight d5, f4 and knight d7, bishop f2 and knight c5, not to exchange anything, and is a small advantage for white, but black can keep the position. After f5, a6, king e7, also the position is painable, of course, but black has to break the king, king d7. I don't like this knight take f2, of course, black exchange pawns, but the position open for the two bishops, okay? The position is opening. So knight g4, bishop d6. We see now the how these two bishops back here control all the square, so the king cannot come. D6 was played, king f3, and bishop f4. Now I think it's the time to make a draw with this move. Knight g4 is a very good move, and I think it is a draw. Black played g5, and now after bishop e5, we see the problem is this f5 pawn, because it's not protected anymore. Knight d7, bishop g7, and now, okay, maybe this is a little bit better to give this pawn, so to play h4 at an appropriate moment to exchange all the pawns on the king side. F4 was played, but after this very good move and g4, white keep the last pawn, because of course this is forced, because this is, this corner is not in the color of the bishop. So if you exchange this, immediately draw. G4, king c6, and take on h6. Now black wants to give this a7 bishop for this g4 pawn, but this is not possible. Okay, king a6, take, and bishop e3. Okay, repeat moves to gain some time in g5. And we see that white has some tempo, because they attack the bishop and they bring this king close to the passed pawn in bishop e5. King e5 and king d7. So a lot of people now try to go to the g8. If it is not possible to go to g8, the best position for the black king is not in front of the pawn, but back to the pawn. So after king f6, the ideal position is for this king to be on g4. Okay, just to know, king e8, and after bishop f4, black is chuzvang. They cannot move the king because king f7 is coming. They cannot move the bishop because after the game, king g7. Okay, very good. Okay, g7 is not possible because this check. King g7, this is theoretically winning position. Bishop h6, king e6. Okay, it's the ideal square, but also with the king on h5, this position lost. Bishop g7, bishop c5, bishop b2, bishop f8, and bishop a3, and black knights. So this, now we'll see some combination. Okay, in this game, analyse with white, a baron tal with black. How another won this position? and you find it. Okay. See, played d4. A very good move. See, all the pieces of black are in this diagonal. So, it is very easy to think of such a motive. Now, if black cannot take on c3, because queen take on c3, and the rook is lost, so black has to take on h7, and now we see that there are a lot of problems on the dark square. 7 was played, queen h4 check, king g8, queen f6, c5, and black resigns. Okay, because after rook f7, we have queen e8, rook f8, and queen take. Something like this. Check. Forced. Okay. So, let's see. Let's go to see the second combination. Second combination is from the game Rachmanov with Pershing. Okay. Can you find how white is winning here? There's a very good motive. E4. Okay. Interference, the queen cannot protect the bishop on d3 and also pin because the pawns cannot take on e4 as the weak on e5 will be lost from the queen on c5. So after e4, white win a piece. They took on e4, they has two pawns, but queen takes e6 is immediately killer, rook b8 and took on d5. So the position is lost. If rook e5, just checking queen d3, saving the rook. So queen f6, take on e4, rook d8, take on a5, and after one, two moves, black. Okay, that's for now, my friends. We'll continue the next time with the part number 3.